What's going on, everybody? It's your girl Tay here. I wanted to get a video out for you guys since this cover that I'm currently working on is taking a little longer than I thought. Reason being is because I want to make sure it's top tier, okay? Because I've been wanting to do this song for a while, so I want to make sure it's fucking phenomenal. It's one of the best covers I've ever done. I decided to do another reaction video, except this time it's not going to be to an entire album. It's just going to be to a song. So as you can probably tell, this will be for Ice Nine Kills' new song, Your Number's Up. I think this is going to be one of the bonus tracks that is going to be on the Silver Scream Deluxe Edition, and I believe that comes out at the end of the month. Or during the same week that I post this, since I suck at posting stuff in a timely manner. That's all I really gotta say about the song, so let's get to it.
Hello? Who's this?
I'm sorry, sir, but I think you have the wrong number.
Just a minute, look, dying. Tell me your name, I'll tell you mine.
My name?
You picked up the phone. Mom and Dad left you alone.
No idea what to say about that. I will admit that the whole song, for the most part, kind of was just like any other song that they've written. So like there wasn't anything that really jumped out at me. It was pretty much all, I don't want to say like it's the same, like they're boring, because Ice Nine Kills is far from boring. I don't know, there just wasn't really anything that really like jumped out at me until the end, because that ending was like, that was graphic, and it wasn't even graphic. I didn't even see anything, but damn, son. I will hand it to them that Ink has a very good history of making use of some interesting audio that they throw into their songs. Like that, for example, what, were they, like, squeezing, like, an orange or something? I don't know, but that sounded at the beginning of Communion of the Curse, they use an actual tape recording from an actual exorcism. So I'm gonna give that to them. That was impressive. The ending of that, I think, was really, really good. As for the rest of the song, it's good. It's good. I'm not gonna lie to you, I was kind of worried about their newer stuff, especially like stuff after the Silver Scream, because the band has gone through a lot of changes. Connor left, what, almost a year, if not a year ago. Justin left. He's currently with Motionless in White. I'm not sure what's going on with JD. He hasn't been really touring with them, so I don't know if he still plays with them or what. I kind of hope he still does, because JD's very talented. But I was kind of worried, because I'm like, well, what if it sounds different? And I mean, every artist and band goes through a change in sound. I mean, Green Day just did it apparently with their new album that I have yet to listen to. I was just scared that it wasn't gonna have like the same feel to it. But it still has that same feel to it, like the theatrical horror to it. If I had to rate this on a scale of 1 to 10, I would probably give this about an 8 out of 10. It was just kind of like every other song that they've had. Like, they always have something going on in the breakdown of the song. But I'm not saying that it's boring. Like I said, Ice Nine Kills was far from boring. I liked it. I mean, it's no Bloodbath and Beyond, but you know. This was actually probably a really short video, especially after I edit this. I don't even want to know how short this video is going to be, but I hope this holds you guys over a little bit until I get that cover out for you guys. I'm going to try and get it out as soon as possible, but also try and make it sound as good as I can. Thank you guys so much for your patience with me, because I suck. But as always, I will see you guys in the next video.